told them.
What I told them.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top yeah. Once again. Yeah.
Tonight, it's the National Football League. Super Bowl 55.
It's been a trying year for everybody, but the tradition continues. Super Bowl 55, away we go from Tampa.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to. And he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who have been there before. Find out how they handle winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things, and then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
First and 10 at the 35-yard
line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts.
Flush to his right. Completes it to Hardman. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Play action is supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Montez Sweat. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop it.
Third and long.
49ers have an extra defensive back on the field. A nickel set for third down.
Here's Hurts to throw.
And the pressure gets to him again. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback because when he's not being hit, as you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
And Hopkins' kick is good.
3 points, probably not going to win this Super Bowl, but at least you get something on the opening drive.
And it's certainly not going to lose it. So the bottom line is, come away with the points now, come back and get greedy later, and try and put it in the end zone.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Are going to stop it as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First time with DeAndre Swift, and he's going to be stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there for him. Second down. Delayed give there out of the gun. Defense was ready.
And I'm not a big fan of a draw play out of the shotgun formation because the quarterback's not having much action where he's getting away from the line of scrimmage. He's catching the football, making a little head fake, and then handing it off. You should be able to read it as they did there.
Throwing on second down, Jackson flushed out right, and he's going to keep it here. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Well, you know, paramount for this defense is trying to keep Lamar Jackson somewhat contained when he tries to run. They did a pretty good job of it there.
And you know what's so difficult for every defense that has to prepare for Lamar Jackson? You have to think and play.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Well, certainly not how he wanted to start his night. First throw of the game, an INT.
Yeah, it's not easy, but he's got to try and wipe that one away from the memory banks. And let's face it, it's not often a quarterback and a defensive back have a lot in common. But one thing, because they have these individual-type plays, they've got to have short memories, don't they? DB gets beat, wipe it away, quarterback throws a pick, has to do the same thing.
The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin, but it'll be second down. Hurts sets up to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Goodwin able to haul it in. And he is going to have a goose first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down. Hurts. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Is caught for a Bills touchdown with the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So giving points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Hopkins with the extra point. And the lead grows to 10-0.
Dustin Hopkins set to kick off.
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Returning it, John Ross. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Simmons on the tackle.
Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Looking to throw on second down. Jackson eluding the pressure right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on a final play of this first quarter. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports.
49ers nothing.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Throwing is Hurts, rolling to his right. Complete, the tight end Kelsey. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
To the right side, it's Kelsey.
Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Not much there, only a yard. Now second and 9 from the 10.
At the 10-yard line.
He'll look to throw. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. That'll be third down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. The quick slant caught. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time.
And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of the season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
29-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, trying to get things settled down a little bit.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
That is definitely what we call our defense an uh-oh play. And what you mean by that is against Lamar Jackson, when you see him out of the pocket, your first thought is, uh-oh, he's going to try and run it. How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Flush to his right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, flushed out right. Got a man open, it's Ross.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their route, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
First and 10 at the
on first and 10 at Swift. Tackled by Isaiah Simmons. 2 minutes remain in this opening half of Super Bowl 55.
It's a pickup of three.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Escaping the pressure right. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Isaiah Simmons on the tackle. It's a gain of five. Brings up third and two.
Jackson from the shotgun. And that will be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. Jackson. That catch good for only a couple.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
And the Niners are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the four-yard line. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. At the four, here's second and goal. Jackson, it'll buy some time right. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Josiah DeGuara there to make the grab. And the 49ers get a score closer. And he'll bang that one through.
Makes the score Bills 17, 49ers 7.
So the lead back down to 10 as things get a little more interesting, and the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You've got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the locker.
That's caught inside the 20. Uh-oh. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Mecole Hardman, 75 yards. And the Bills will extend their lead.
Justin Hopkins on 40 extra points.
Didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, give that water break and get on out there and play.
The
49er offense set to get this drive underway. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw again. Jackson. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted.
Picked up by Denzel Ward. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll roll him out right. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. So we've reached halftime here in Super Bowl 55. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Both teams ready after the halftime spectacle, and we are back underway in Super Bowl 55. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision, loses him about 4 yards. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Incomplete. Makes it second and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Throwing again. Jackson flushed out right. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson. And they take him down. The Bills get to him.
I think we've seen this before. Someone's down 3 scores. That situation there is just going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, not bad. Number 3 right now. 3-score game, third quarter, 3 and out. Not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes.
Hardman on the return.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A great return there, bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And the Bills are going to take over in great position here with a first and 10.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
Escaping the pressure right. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Fabian Moreau. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down. The young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, The NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Henry Ruggs, the intended receiver.
And that'll bring up second down.
It leads to second and 10.
To throw again. Jackson eluding the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Yeah, he's got the hook up to Ruggs.
17 yards on the play as they try to eat into this 17-point deficit. Play action. Now Jackson steps away to his left. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. Flush to his right. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there.
That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
They go play action with Jackson. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive, and not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
And they'll look to throw here. Sliding out of the pocket. And he's got a man here. Complete. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. Caught, Kelsey, left side. And they'll get him down up past the 15.
Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
So a little breathing room now. First and 10 at the 17. They're going to look to throw. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 26. A big play here for the Bills. 57 yards.
26-yard line.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Tony Pollard, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Bills will add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line.
At their own 19-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
I think it's safe to say this is a game he's not going to forget anytime soon, Charles. Three interceptions.
It's rare that we see three interceptions by one team, let alone by an individual. And I think that after the second one, he's probably telling his teammates, any ball that's in the air, it's going to be mine. And that turned out to be true.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Escaping the pressure right. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Give him 30 yards there.
37-yard line.
Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. From the gun, it's Hurts. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
48-yard line.
Back to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Given 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
The Bills on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Eluding the pressure right. That's complete to a speedy wideout. Goodwin. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down.
First and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Here's Hurts to throw. Rolling to his right. He's got his man on the crossing route. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 11 more on that one, and another first down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Bills, first down. First and goal at the 3.
Now here's Pollard. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. They'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a 3rd time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Going to run again here with Pollard. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Buffalo. Tony Pollard with his 3rd touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Bills head on. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all 3 phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review.
At their own 23-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory as they have been outplayed tonight.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Throwing again, Jackson. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Calais Campbell just would not be denied. That's a loss of seven. The Niners on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 17. Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long. From the gun, Jackson dancing to his left. And he's going to go down again.
Jackson sacked. A loss of 3 yards. And it's three and out.
Here's Jamie Gillen now. Super Bowl 55 down to the final 2 minutes. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Here's Hardman to return. Said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10.
33-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they are trying to play it cool down on the sidelines, but they know that they are very close now to wrapping this thing up and letting the celebration begin. A Super Bowl title within reach now as they try to polish this thing off. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Pollard again, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10. This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays, and they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones.
It's caught at the 10. And they do finally get him. But he makes it all the way to the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
6-yard line.
And these Bills make the 90s seem like a distant memory. Buffalo is the Super Bowl champion. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
Champs, the Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
Responsible without your money or not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess. You ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, a cheater, run up and I'm airing the scene. I'm just like Vegeta, prince, and I'm an heir to the sea. As around my chest, but they don't mean the man to steal it. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the fresh, but ain't half the man as well. Are you
irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't want to bust. So they boo each other, think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break, but me and myself talk too. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And
and there's no catch. I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 and it's back. Told them all, you at first, you last. Little boy, that's facts. I'ma throw that cash to my money.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coincide. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why new people try to define infrastructure right on black time. Infrastructure right on.
Get them high.